Welcome to Remote Learning on Seesaw. This training is designed for free and paid teachers who are already set up with an account and class in Seesaw. Be sure to have another device or window ready so you can follow along with the steps. By the end of this video, you will know how remote learning is different than classroom learning, be all set up on Seesaw, have a plan, and know the three levers for designing activities for learning at home. At Seesaw, our mission is to bring teachers, students, and families together to deepen student learning. We have always supported strong homeschool partnerships, and we are excited to help deepen those partnerships with remote learning. Remote learning is different than classroom learning. A student's home is always a powerful learning environment, but it's not realistic to expect you can replicate the school day remotely. Remote learning is most effective when learning experiences integrate the family and home environment, and when families and teachers work together to support learning. While we want to support students to work independently, we also want to provide families with the tools they need to support their child when they need it. All right, let's get students set up for remote learning. If your students sign in with email or Clever, they can continue to log in this way at home. You will need to update your privacy settings to protect student privacy while they're working outside of the classroom. In class settings, scroll down to the student section and turn off students can see each other's work. You'll know it's turned off if it's gray, not green. You can skip the rest of this step. If your students do not use email to sign in, you will need home learning codes. We created home learning codes to allow students to log into the Seesaw class app securely from home. You may be wondering, what's the difference? Your class code is one code for all students. This works great when you're in the classroom to make sure that students log in as themselves. When students are learning at home, you need a more secure way for students to log in. Home learning codes are unique to each student, so you don't need to worry about any login mistakes. By default, home learning codes also keep each student's journal private, so students and families cannot see the work of other students while at home. To access home learning codes, sign in on a computer. On your teacher dashboard, you will see a banner and a button that says Get Home Learning Codes. It looks like this. You can find it up here. You can also access home learning codes in class settings. Students will need their unique home learning codes to log into the Seesaw class app securely from home. You have two options. You can print PDFs of students' codes by clicking the Print Codes button here. You'll get an instructions page and a PDF for each student that looks like this. Or you can press download codes to generate a spreadsheet with students' names, text codes, and QR code generator. You can send these codes home via text or email, which is especially handy if your school is already closed. Seesaw for Schools teachers, your admin may access codes for you. You'll know because you'll see this box when you click Get Home Learning Codes. If you see this, contact your admin. All right, pause the video now and set up Seesaw for remote learning. No matter how students log in, with email or with home learning codes, students will need the Seesaw Class app for remote learning. They will need to download the most up-to-date version of the Class app or visit app.seesaw.me on a web browser. If families have multiple children sharing a device to access Seesaw, each child will need to log in and out each time they use it. We recommend printing and hanging their home learning codes in the learning area to make it easier. Now that Seesaw is set up for remote learning, we recommend creating a plan. There are three considerations our teachers have found most helpful. First, how many activities will you assign? Remember, the goal is not to replicate your school day, but to focus on your class's high priority learning goals. One way to guide your planning is to consider the average attention span for your age group and design learning blocks appropriate for your students. Keep in mind that these are just averages, and you know your students best. In between learning blocks, encourage students and families to take brain breaks. This helps reset students' attention so they can jump right back into the next learning task when the break is over. This brain break routine is a great one to share with families. You can find the link to this activity in the video description. Second, what about feedback? How will you interact with student work and how often? There are two easy ways to provide feedback in Seesaw. To give feedback to a specific student, you can add a text or audio comment on student work. Or to give feedback to the whole class or a small group of students, you can post to the class journal. We recommend filming a video of yourself explaining the feedback or sharing a picture of what you want students to know. Post to all students or select a small group. Most importantly, make sure your feedback plan is sustainable over time. The third consideration is all about routines. Routines help students feel safe and secure, especially during times of change and uncertainty. Here are some suggestions. You already worked so hard to establish consistent routines in your classroom. So think about how you can take those routines and make them work remotely. Since you don't have those one-on-one moments with students and families built into your day, how can you designate time for check-ins or office hours? Even a few routines will make a huge difference. Pause the video now and jot down your ideas for your remote learning plan. Creating activities for learning at home is different than regular lesson planning. Here are three levers you can use to make your activities most effective for home learning. First, include family members. Students don't have their classmates at home, so facilitate interaction among family members instead. Simulations, role plays, and interviews are great ways to do this. But you can also infuse everyday moments to reinforce learning, like practicing symmetry while folding laundry or fractions while cooking. The more interaction with family members, the better. Second, include physical objects. Talk about culturally responsive pedagogy. Make learning relevant by using what students have around them. How about a shape scavenger hunt? Using old clothes to act out a favorite scene? Students will have so much fun using everyday objects to learn. Third, include open-ended questions. Remote learning means students have the time and space to really explore what they find interesting. Take advantage of this by creating activities that allow students to investigate, look at things from multiple perspectives, and problem solve in fun new ways. Let their curiosity shine. Think of an activity that leverages one or more of these levers. Pause the video now to jot it down. If you're getting stuck, you can take a look at the ready-to-share activities we have created specifically for remote learning at web.seesaw.me/curriculum. Way to go! You're ready for remote learning. Get ready to see some amazing student and family learning on Seesaw. Trust us, even though you're not physically together, you'll still be able to build strong relationships with students and families during this time. Thanks for spending time with us today. We hope you'll join us for future trainings. See you again soon here at Seesaw.